Okay, so today I'm going to show you the third album, third journal that I made. It was a series. The first one that I showed you was this one, the red one. The second one I showed you was the blue one, with, you know, the little flowers at the corner. And the last one is this one, the yellow one. I bought them, the three, when they were blank. I bought them all together, and I'm going to show you what is inside. I kept this one for the end because actually it's kind of hard for me to show it, because it shows a period which was not my most glorious one, if I can say it like that. It seems that I partly did it just when my husband left, my ex-husband left. So, of course, it's a little weird for me to go back to that. And I don't even understand the chronology in this journal, because I see at the end things that for sure I made when my ex-husband was still there and still my husband. And then I see pages which are before the last ones, where obviously he had left. So I don't understand, maybe I didn't make the pages in the right order. I don't know. Actually, I don't even remember when, how I did that. I was not in my best shape then. And there are a lot of things that I forgot about that period, probably because I was so bad. And I think that maybe my mind wants to forget, you know, the worst part. So there are things, of course, that I remember clearly. But I made some stuff in art and craft. In my mind, I was doing nothing, but obviously it's not the case, because I find things that I was making. I don't know. I don't understand. The cover is a little dirty. I will have to find a way to clean that, because it's some paper, but I can't wash it. But I will have to find a way to fix that. I absolutely love the drawings here. That's why I bought these journals in the first place. Anyway, I start. Let's do it. So first page, it's some watercolor. But obviously, I think that I put a clear gesso varnish on that, because I can feel the texture, because the watercolor don't give this kind of texture, but for sure that is watercolor. So that is something that I did much before my ex-husband left. I probably tried if the watercolors were working on this kind of paper, I suppose. So here, actually, I wrote that on an envelope and I kept that. It's Mr. and Mrs. Igor Bolender. Igor is the name of my ex-husband. I think that I kept that just for the address, because it's where we used to live and I love this place. Referendum, no. So, you know, we voted for something there, but I don't remember what it was. I'm wondering if it was not for the European Constitution, something like that, and I think that I voted no. 2001 nights, it's like mille et une nuits, you know, it's the name of a book, of a tale. And I kept the card because I like that. It's a place, it's a store, and that was another store which was close to my home. Oh, this paper, that is some tissue paper. I kept it because I love the idea of the dog on a trampoline. I don't know why, the idea of a dog on a trampoline makes me laugh. So I'm sorry for this page. If you are shocked, I apologize. I have no idea why I was so obsessed with the packaging of condoms. It probably meant something for me then, but I can't remember what. And I wrote so much pain. It's not related to sex, I can tell you. I think that probably my ex-husband left already and I was talking about that. Fortunately for me, I've never been raped or hurt in an intimate moment, so don't worry about that. I kept these stamps because I like the colors. Drôle d'endroit pour une rencontre. I think it's the name of a restaurant where we went. That's probably why I kept that, but I like the card too. And, well. Oh, okay, so this is obviously a card coming from Japan. And that is a card from my older son because he left to Japan. And he wrote to us, oh yeah, so if it's when he left to Japan, definitely it's when my ex-husband left, because my older son left just before my ex-husband left the home. And when my son left, we already knew that we were going to get separated. So obviously I made that. Wow, so really, I didn't remember that I did that in my condition I was then. That's the point of a journal, that it's a kind of a witness of events, and then you look at that and you remember. But that's weird, because I can't remember doing craft while being in that situation. So obviously I was making some, but maybe without realizing that I was doing that. And here, yes, I wrote, mon fifi, c'est au Japon, it means my son is in Japan. And this is some Japanese fabric and some Japanese paper for origami. That is a Japanese cat, you know, it's for good fortune and good money. Oh, this, you are not going to believe what it is. I painted on a piece of furniture, and I don't know what happened, maybe because of humidity, or maybe I didn't prepare the piece of furniture well. All the paint peeled off, but in pieces, and I kept a piece of the peeled off and I glued it here. So it's great because I remember this piece of furniture that I painted. Sorry, I have a, not a cold, I think it's more allergy, and my nose is a little running, sorry about that. So SBC, yes. So obviously that was when I moved to LA. So it was in 2006. SBC was the company of the phone, if I remember well, but it doesn't exist anymore. I'm wondering if it's not the ex AT&T, or I don't know, I don't remember. International Priority Mail. So that is a piece of paper which was wrapping some soap sold at Anthropology. Same thing for that. For me, Anthropology equal Los Angeles, even if there are many stores in the US, not only in Los Angeles. But I absolutely love Anthropology. These are real flowers, dried flowers that I glued. I didn't dry them myself. I could buy them like that in an art and craft shop, but it was in Paris. But maybe you can find some in the US as well, or somewhere else. And here, même les choses les plus belles peuvent faire mal. So obviously I was talking about that. It means even the most beautiful things may hurt. And yes, my marriage was a very successful one. We have been together 20 years and a half till he left. Oh, Le Kitsch was a store just beside my home. That is a dry flower that I dried myself. But you see how the color change, it becomes more brownish yellow with time. So here I wrote le retour de la joie, so the comeback of joy. I don't know how I could write that, because that was in December 2005 and it was at my worst moment. Je suis transie d'amour. Oh là, oh yeah, okay, I'm not going to read. That is painful for me to read that, not because I'm still sad about it. It's more that I'm sad about seeing how I was then. I don't care anymore about my ex-husband. It doesn't mean that I hate him, but he's still the father of my younger son, but I'm not hurting about that anymore. It's just that it makes me sad to see me how I was then. Oh yes, that is a store where I used to buy a lot of linen for us. Oh, I'm sorry. Yes. Definitely allergies. I'm sorry. I glued some bubble wrap, probably to see if it was gluing, and also it's an image, it's like to protect myself, you know. Obviously, I made the two pages together because I wrote here and here. Oh, that is the crown that we give for the day of the Magi, you know. It's a French tradition. In love forever. Oh yeah, well, that's what I thought then. Oh, Tiosha is a tea that it's a black tea that I was drinking to lose some weight. It works really well. I'm trying to find some here, but I didn't find so far. Harry Potter. Okay, I don't know what it was. Maybe a book that I bought for my son. Oh no, maybe we went to see a movie. Maybe, yeah. Maybe a little Halloween. Oh, it's weird because every time I start filming, my nose is running. I don't know why. So you see, there was probably a restaurant ticket here, and it completely. Oh yes, Chez Clément. It's the name of a restaurant, but with time it completely faded. But it's good because the memory is fading too, and it's perfect. Here, my first transfer on fabric. So yes, this was test I was doing to transfer some images on fabric and jeans, you know, denim fabric. Oh, this is a place on Venice Beach where we used to go a lot. This is some Indian fabric. That is a true leaf, these two. And I was working with probably some pastels in the background, I suppose, and watercolors. So here he is. So the image is damaged, but I kept it because I liked it like that. That was my ex-husband. Of course, he's getting older now, so he doesn't look as young as he was on this photo. So I wrote, Igor is my love forever. No. It's not true. Igor is not my love forever. And it's great. That is some fabric. It's really nice. That was wrapping an orange. This is a Japanese fabric. This is a paper to glue, which is a little like a tissue paper. And obviously I received an envelope from Switzerland. I don't know why, because I know I knew nobody there. Now I know some people there, but then no. Oh, obviously Igor is everywhere. Oh, I wrote Le Monde Flou d'Igor. It means the blurry world of Igor. Igor, I don't know how we say in English. In French we say Igor. So why blurry? My ex-husband, his astrological sign is Pisces. And he always has a tendency to be a little blurry, which was not working really well with me because I'm Virgo and I like the very tangible things and sure things. But we have been working during more than 20 years, so why the eyes? You know, it's eyes that we buy at art and craft store. Because he was buying that and gluing that on his keyboards, so it was making us laugh anyway. So when I see eyes like that, it makes me laugh because it reminds me that period where we were gluing eyes everywhere. Anyway, he was very crafty too, obviously, for a musician. That is a French metro ticket, a Parisian metro ticket more exactly. Attention, ceci n'est pas un billet. So it was, Acme, it was, oh yeah. It was a concert where my son went. It's a band, a French band. I don't know if they still exist. And I went with my younger son. concert de Laszlo, Vache, that is some leather coming from something. Still, my ex-husband, he's everywhere. Oh, this one is really nice. So here I drew this woman, and the fabric is coming from really it's a fabric from the 60s that I still have. And I was creating a model of a dress which would fit the 60s period. I remember because my mother was wearing these kinds of dresses, and I glued some sequins. So, you know, I like the sequins and the glitter. And what did I write? Mode chic and cool. Okay, mode, it means fashion in French. That is some lace. That is something that I found in the street and that I glued. I love gluing things from the street. Do you see it? Yes, it looks like a C. It's in metal. That was coming from a pashmina I had. Fabric. What else? Some wool. A little flower. Stamps. Fabric here, stamps. Business card. An address of someone, another fabric. I love polka dots, morty. Oh, that is some a material that I use sometimes. Oh, I love this page. Indian musician with a flower. That is, yes, some pastels. Le mal d'aimé, it means the pain of love. I don't know if we can translate it like that. British stamps. Yes, it was obviously coming from Essex in United Kingdom. I absolutely love the British stamps. That's why I always keep them. And tea. I don't know from what it was coming. The excellent Japanese. Oh, sake. So that's probably my older son who brought that back. And I love the tags on the bottles. I often keep them. These are some... probably oil pastels, and an eye that I drew, trying to be a little faster because it's long. Oh yes, I have many like that. It's like ribbons. I glued that. Oh, this was a bracelet. You know, you buy it, you attach it to your wrist, and when it breaks, your wish is realizing. And my wish then was to move to the US, and it really happened when the bracelet broke. So I have another bracelet here that I don't remove because I want to see if it's going to work. But you must not tell your wish, otherwise it could cancel it. Well, I don't know, you know, I do that, I don't know, but for that it really worked well, and I liked so much this bracelet that I wanted to keep it. That was on some cotton thread, the name of a brand of underwears, I think. Oh, these fantastic stamps which were made in France. That is Jean-Louis Scherrer, but many designers made some. The Christian Lacroix one is fantastic. A vintage fabric, an Indian from the 60s fabric, an image that I loved. Plaisir d'offrir, it means the pleasure of giving a gift. I found that in the street. It's a U. It's a kind of metal. A drawing. Oh, it was coming from a hand cream that I bought at Marks and Spencer, and I loved it so much that I kept the packaging, the tag. That was a little paper bag. I loved so much the print that I kept it. That is a doily paper, a paper doily. Zoom. Okay. More things. So images that I kept, tea, tickets. Oh, that is a paper to make cigarettes. I don't smoke, but my ex-husband used to have a collection of these kinds of paper, and I kept them. Oh, that is some toilet paper from the 60s. You see what we were doing then? Isn't it fantastic? I wanted to keep it. We don't find papers like that anymore. And vous hésitez? Are you hesitating? I like this image from India, and the bag, I loved it so much that I glued the image, more stamps, vintage fabric. So you see, Le Pont de la Lune, that is something that I drew before my husband left. So probably I made that at the end. I don't know, I don't understand. Le Pont de la Lune, I dreamt that I was on a bridge, to make short, and the name of the bridge was the Bridge of the Moon. And there were some holes on the bridge to hide. That was my dream, I don't know what it means, but I wanted to represent it, to remember it, so I made that with pencils, as you can see, colored pencils and black pencils. More tea, more stamp, more condom. Oh, a leaf that I bought in an art and craft store. I have many like these. Les chevaux de la mer, so it means the horses of the sea. Barcelona, Spain. That's funny because I knew nobody in Barcelona, but now my older son lives in Spain. That is another paper that I bought, and I think that's it. Yes, that's it. Oh, a lot of cat hair, sorry about that. But I like always to put things which are hanging, like tags. Bazaar, fragile cheminée en bois. You know, like wool, all kind of tags. I love doing that. Oh, this is a kind of something, but which is thick to glue. I have a lot like this. I bought that at the Galerie Lafayette, at the art and craft department of the store. And yes, that's it. So you understand why I was hesitating to show you that, because it doesn't remind me the best period of my life. But when I see things like that, I'm rather proud of what I made. It seems that even in the pain, I was able to do fun things. And even this page here, I like it a lot. And I was right to do the drawing, so then I can remember my dream. That is a good thing to do in a journal, drawing a dream that we had. I particularly like this page. That is some silk flower. I love that, and I like how I used the oil pastels. I think that it's the oil pastels which are water soluble, I think. But okay, now you know everything, or almost. This one is also a good one. It was a good place to do some watercolor. It was a kind of Indian paper, very particular. Anyway, I hope that you liked it. I don't like usually to show my personal things on camera because it's kind of embarrassing, you know, but it's also the feelings, the way we are, which makes good journals. If you have no feelings at all, if you feel nothing, you can express nothing in a journal. So I hope you liked it, and I will see you very soon, of course. Bye bye, bye bye everybody. Bye bye.